If you are experiencing FC25 Squad Battles Crash on PC, then you are at the right place. We have got some easy ways that you can use to fix this issue. Welcome back to Silicophilic, your go-to source for tech tips and fixes. Method 1. Run FC25 with administrative privileges. Sometimes the game files may require administrative privileges to run. So run FC25 as an administrator. Here is how you can do so. Right-click on the application you are using to launch the game. Next, select Show More options. Open Properties, go to the Compatibility tab. Check the box for Run this program as an administrator. Click on Apply and then on OK to save the changes. Method 2. Try a different compatibility mode. Another thing you can do is change the compatibility mode. To do that, open the game properties. Then go to the Compatibility tab. Check the box for Run this program in compatibility mode for the option. Select the Windows version and click on Apply and then on OK. Method 3. Verify the integrity of the game files. Missing or corrupted game files can also cause issues like this. So verify the game files. Here is how you can verify the integrity of the game files for Steam platform. Head to the Steam library, right-click on the game and open its properties. Go to the Install Files tab and click on the Verify Integrity of the Game Files option. Wait till Steam verifies the game files and download the missing file or fix the corrupted game files. Once done, launch the game and check. Method 4. Update graphics drivers and run the game on the dedicated graphics card. Right-click on the Windows Search button and choose Device Manager. Go to the Display Adapter section and expand it. Right-click on your graphics driver and choose Update Driver option. From the next window, select the Search Automatically for Drivers option. Follow the on-screen instructions to download and install the latest driver. You can also visit the official websites of your graphics card manufacturer to update your graphics drivers. These websites are linked in the description below. Now download the latest drivers for the graphics card installed on your computer from these websites. Follow the on-screen instructions to complete the driver installation process. Once done, restart your PC. When the device restarts, open the app again to check for updates. Download and install the available updates. If you have multiple GPUs for your computer, then make sure you use the one exclusively for gaming. This ensures a better gaming experience. So using the dedicated GPU for gaming can avoid issues while playing games like FC25. Here is how you can check if you are running the dedicated graphics card. However, this depends upon your operating system and the graphics card you are using. Press the Windows key plus R to launch the Run utility. Type devmgmt.msc in the Run command box and hit Enter or click on OK. Expand the Display Adapters section. Here you will find the two adapters, one for your dedicated graphics card and the integrated graphics card. The dedicated graphics card should have a longer and more specific name than the integrated one. The dedicated graphics card may also have a higher memory size listed. So run the game with the dedicated graphics card. Method 5. Launch the game through the game installation folder. You can also try launching the game from its installation folder directly and not from Steam platform and see if this can fix the issue. Open Steam and then head to Library. Right-click on the game, go to Properties, select Install Files and click on Browse. This should take you to the game installation folder. Try launching the game from here. If the error persists, move on to the next solution. Method 6. Install Anti-Cheat. Make sure you install EA Anti-Cheat from EA websites only. Here is the link. We have also provided it in the description below. Open this link in your web browser and download the EA Anti-Cheat installer. Once the download is complete, you can run this .exe file. Click on Yes to allow. Then click on this down arrow and select FC25. Next, click on Update so that you can make sure everything is up to date. Now run the game and check. Method 7. Rename the FC25 folder. Open File Explorer. Open this PC. Then go to your C drive. Open the Users folder and then open your user profile. Open App Data. If you cannot find it, go to the View tab. Then and select Show Then. Check the Hidden Folder option. Now you should be able to see the App Data folder. Open it and head to the local folder. Inside this, open the ESports FC25 folder. Now you can rename this folder. Like here, we are renaming this folder. You can also delete the folder, but if you do so, it will delete all the game saves. So you can take a backup and then perform the steps. Method 8. Try a lower resolution. Press the Windows plus I keys to open settings. Click on System, then select Display. Scroll down and click on Graphics. Click on the Browse option and head to the Game Installation folder. Select Game EXE and add it. You will now see it here. Click on Options and select High Performance. Select Save to save the changes. You can also try a lower resolution from Settings. To do that, go to Windows Settings, click on the System tab and select Display. Then head to Display Resolution. You can try a lower resolution than the recommended one for your PC and check if the game loads now. Method 9. Disconnect external server devices. Next, disconnect any external devices like HOTAS, pedals, racing wheel, Razer Tartarus. Make sure to disconnect all the additional USB adapter connected to PC and disconnect any additional joystick or controllers. Once done, restart the PC and then launch the game and check. Method 10. Disable overlay features. Open Steam library, find the game and right-click on it. Go to its properties. Now go to the General tab and check the Enable the Steam Overlay While In-Game option. You should also disable other overlay apps like Discord, GeForce Experience, Nvidia Shadowplay Overlay or AMD Overlay before playing the game. Method 11. Allow the game through the firewall. Another potential cause of this issue could be firewall interference. So you can check that by allowing the game through firewall and your antivirus program. Here we are showing how to allow the game through Windows Security. Open the Windows Security app using the search menu. Now click on the Firewall and Network Protection option. After that, tap on the Allow an app through firewall option from the right side pane and then press the Change Settings button. Next, click on Allow another app button and then press the Browse button to select the game .exe file. Click on Open and then click on the Add button. You will now see the game under the list of allowed apps and features. Tick the checkbox associated with the game and enable it on both public and private networks. Once done, you can press the OK button to save the changes. Finally, you can relaunch the game file and check if it is loading properly. Method 12. Update your Windows OS. Windows updates can help resolve issues with gaming performance. Also, updating Windows to the latest version ensures your computer runs with the latest security and performance enhancements. Type Check for Updates in the search menu and select the top option. Click on the Check for Updates button. If any update is available, download and install the updates. Restart your PC for that. Now launch the game and see if this could resolve the issue. Method 13. Close unnecessarily running programs. Sometimes streaming and downloading can compete for resources and cause issues while playing games like FC25. So close unnecessary apps to free up bandwidth for FC25. Right-click on the Windows Start button and select Task Manager. Go to the Processes tab and right-click on the processes you want to close. Select the End Task option. Repeat the same for each task you want to kill. Then exit the window. Method 14. Increase VRAM. The more VRAM your system's graphics card has, the more data it can store. So this will enable it to handle higher resolution textures and run your game smoothly without crashing. Here is how you can increase the VRAM. Type Advanced System Settings in the Windows search menu and select the top search result. Under Performance, click Settings. Go to the Advanced tab. Under Virtual Memory, click Change. Uncheck Automatically Manage Paging File Size for All Drives. Choose the drive where you want to store the paging file. Select Custom Size. In the Initial Size field, enter a value equal to 1.5 times of your total available RAM. In the Maximum Size field, enter a value that is 3 times of your total RAM. To check that, open Windows Settings and then from the System, select About. Check the RAM. Once you have set the value, click on Set, then OK twice. Then restart your PC. Method 15. Method 15, flush DNS and reset WinSock. Flushing the DNS will clear all the DNS cache. You can also reset the network settings. If the game is crashing due to network-related issues, then this should fix the problem. Here is how to do so. Type cmd in the search menu and right-click on the command prompt. Select to run as administrator. Copy and paste the following commands in the elevated command prompt window. Press the enter button after each command. ipconfig/flushdns, ipconfig/release, ipconfig/renew, netshintipreset, netshwinsockreset. Once done, restart your PC and then launch the game and check. Method 16, install the Visual C++ redistributables. Next, you can install the Visual C++ redistributables. What you need to do is search Visual C++ redistributables in Google. Click on the first link of Microsoft.com. We also have provided the link in this description, so you don't have to search. Download the Visual Current C++ redistributables available. Remember to download the correct architecture, like downloading x64 for 64-bit systems and x86 for 32-bit systems. Install the downloaded file as shown. Now restart your PC. After the PC restarts, run the game and the issue should be fixed. Method 17. Install DirectX. Another thing you can do is install DirectX. Type in DirectX on Google and click on the top option for Microsoft. You can also click on the link given in the description. Download the DirectX setup file and after the download is complete, run the exe file. Click on Yes to continue. Follow the on-screen instructions to finish the downloading process or follow as shown. Make sure to uncheck Bing bar box. Let the installation process complete. After it is complete, restart your PC and then try to launch the game and check. Method 18. Avoid overclocking and update bias. Overclocking the system can boost performance, but sometimes it can crash the system, especially while playing games like FC25. So you can disable overclocking while playing the game. To do that, boot into your BIOS or UEFI settings. The process of booting into BIOS differs from system to system. You can check the manufacturer's website for the exact process to boot into your BIOS. You can also take the help of the user manual to boot into your BIOS. Here are the basic steps to enter into BIOS or the UEFI settings. Open your Windows settings, select Recovery from the right pane, then click on the Restart Now button next to Advanced Startup. Once your PC restarts, select Troubleshoot, then go to Advanced Options. Then you should find the UEFI firmware settings. Once you boot into your BIOS or UEFI settings, navigate to the overclocking section and then disable it. You should close all the overclocking apps if you are using one like MSI Afterburner or similar applications. If you are using an outdated version of the BIOS, then this can also be why you are having issues while playing FC25. Each motherboard is different, so go through the manual of your motherboard to know how to update your BIOS. Follow the instructions to complete updating BIOS. After updating BIOS, you should not get the error. And there you have it, the methods to fix the FC25 Squad Battles crash on PC. We hope one of these methods have worked for you. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more tech tips and troubleshooting guides. Leave a comment and help others know which solution solved your problem. Thanks for watching, and we will see you in the next video.